In front of my melody, you are all that matters. You are.
Hello, everyone. It's such a joy to be back here again. My name is Elizabeth Isola. I have a strong passion to help you live again, to become a better you. Today, I'm here with a message of hope for you. There is hope for you today. It takes hope to come out of failure and commence the process of creating a new beginning of success. There is power in hope. The first thing that happens to most people who have setbacks is that they become discouraged and hopeless. But today I want you to know that there is hope. Sometimes you see them wondering, can anything good still come my way? Can I make it again? Will I ever regain lost glory and respect? The answer is hope again. They look around them and feel, what am I living for? I might as well end it now. Listen to me, people. Hope is a sustainer of life. Hopelessness makes one think of death. Hopelessness makes one think of suicide. But I want you to know that there is hope for you. Even if you have a terminal disease now, there is hope for you. Have you lost a loved one? Your relationship that you invested in just ended and you are feeling used? There is hope for you. You lost a precious asset? There is hope. You have failed in the last 3 years. You have failed over and over and over again. Please don't give up. There is hope for you. Until the race is over, it is not over for you. You are a nurturer. The hopelessness of a woman makes things die and wither. Even if your joy is withered away, don't lose hope. Joy will come again. Weeping may endure for the night, but your joy comes in the morning. Don't cut your life short by losing hope. Listen to me. If you lose hope, you cut your life short. The Bible says in the book of Job chapter 14 from verse 7 to 9, for there is hope of a tree. If it be cut down, that it will sprout again, and that the tender branch thereof will not cease. The roots thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk die off in the ground. Yet through the scent of water it will bud and bring forth boughs like a plant. I tell you the truth, at the scent of water, that plant will come alive. And today you are coming alive. Job suffered so much calamities in his life, but he said, if a tree can have hope, why won't I have hope? So listen to me, a tree that has been cut off can come alive again if water is poured on it. I came here with a word of hope that will be poured on you to help you to come alive. So no matter the situation of your life, refuse to give up on yourself. No matter the contributions people make towards your life and success, listen to me, it's not more than 25%. No matter the help people give to you, it's not more than 25%. The remaining 75% of your life is in your hands and is made up of your personal input. So rise up again, shine again, live again. I want you to say to yourself today, there is hope for me. Don't judge me yet. I am still under construction. God is still working on me. So the true me is yet to emerge. Don't give up on yourself. Now, how do you stir up hope? I want you to stir up hope. How do you stir up hope? Listen, there are ways you can stir up hope. You can come out of hopelessness and become hopeful by taking the following steps. The first step is for you to look ahead. Look ahead. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2 says, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Look ahead. The way out of hopelessness is to see a tomorrow. see a great future set before you, and then stir up your hope for it, because there is actually a tomorrow that is better than today. Jesus overlooked the death of hanging, the shame. He overlooked the suffering. Why? Because he knew that the cross was not his end. I am bold to say to you today that that thing you are going through is not your end. It is not your end. There is a better tomorrow. What's number two? Number two way of stirring up hope is let the past pass. Let the past pass. You can't look in two directions at the same time now. You are either looking forward or backward. Regard the past as past and refuse to look backward. In Genesis chapter 26, verse 13, the Bible says Isaac went forward because he was ever looking ahead and not backwards. So stop referring to the past. Stop talking about it. Stop thinking about it. How do you stir up hope? Number three, refuse sympathy. Stop looking for those who will pity you. Those who will not inspire you. All they do is pity you. Stop it. Look for those that will inspire you. Number four, ignore scorners. Ignore those who laugh at you. Fix your eyes on the future. Ignore mockers. Of course, they will mock at you now. Didn't they mock Jesus? They will laugh at you. They will laugh when you fall. They will laugh when you sleep. But raise up your head, because you have a God that won't fail you. Lean on that God. And the fifth way of helping stir up hope is to encourage yourself. Listen to me. Encourage yourself. The Bible said David encouraged himself. David came back one day from battle. And what did he see? He saw that he had lost everything. But he did not give up. He encouraged himself. Even his closest friends wanted to kill him. They felt, look, we will kill you. You have messed us up finally. The Bible says David encouraged himself in the Lord. So encourage yourself. Now, how do you stir up hope again? Be conscious of the presence of God. Know that his word said he will not leave you. Know that he said he will not forsake you. So whether you are in the valley, whether you are in the pit, wherever you find yourself in the journey of life, one thing is definite. He won't leave you and he won't forsake you. Psalm 23 verse 4. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. So don't give up. Have a sense of appreciation. Small plus small equals big. Be appreciative of those small, small things. Are you still alive? That's a big deal. Celebrate your life. Be appreciative of the gift of life. Small plus small equals big. It's foolishness to compete or compare with others. That's what the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 12 says. It is foolishness for you to want to be like the next person. You are unique. You are special. Be you. And then trust God for the best. I see you celebrating a beautiful tomorrow. I'm seeing it. I see you dancing tomorrow. I see people congratulating you tomorrow. It's a beautiful tomorrow for you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like and subscribe to watch more videos that will inspire you. See you next time. Put you in front.